this is my great-great-grandfather, Ned Thompson, and his wife. They supposed to have been the last slave to come into to Texas. I did some research, and when I read another article on him, that he could speak his native language, just could speak his native language. And that was surprising to me that he could do that after he, you know, he came over here. He'd been dealing with stuff for so long, you get frustrated, you get tired, and I got to a point where I got getting tired of fooling with. Next to that oak tree right there, that's where my grandfather and grandmother buried up close to that fence over there by that oak tree. I don't know if that's the right one until I get over there and see or get close enough where I can see it. Well, it's not family, it's kin people that was involved and got family buried out here. Wanted to visit the grave, but after all this, when they started talking about money, that went a lot of them backed out because they didn't have the money to fight. Why should a husband be buried in this cemetery and a wife buried in another cemetery? That's not right. I think everybody that married and they loved one died, they'll be able to be buried where their family instead of be buried somewhere else. See, he do that all the time. I'm gonna stand close to you. He probably pointing at me. I'm gonna see, can he get you over here? He'll show it to the owner when he come down. Now he might be going to get his camp card now, because he can't get it on the phone. I feel like he's harassing me when he's sitting up there shooting a video camera towards your window, and then stopping in front of your house, sitting in front of your house with a video camera. All I was trying to do is get access to the cemetery. And I have to watch myself all the time because I don't know what might happen when I'm down in the woods. Or sheriffs have been out here 10 and 12 times and never did nothing. If there's a cemetery law, people ought to abide by the law. And people that know the laws ought to abide by it. I've been fighting this for 10 years. And we'd have been to every source to try to find help, to try to get this problem resolved.
Let's invoke our ancestors. I'd like to invoke Maddie Jean Jones, Edward Jones.
I'd like to invoke Eleanor Myers.
Ashe. I'd like to invoke Rosalie and Goldie Teller.
Ashe.
We call out to their spirits to guide us, and we give them thanks for our lineage.
Ashe. There has to be a vehicle for document around the state of Texas the location of every cemetery, because when these large highway projects, just like the I-69 project that is currently being planned for the state of Texas, they destroy thousands of cemeteries that are not documented. Slave cemeteries do not have markers, and if there are no markers, many times people fail to know that they exist. Those people are just as much a part of our culture and are just as important as the folks who had markers. That's what Project Respect seeks to do, is we seek to bring the genealogy, we seek to bring the historical research. The most important thing, we seek to find a vehicle that we make that data generally available.
What we're doing is bringing awareness to our youth that they can be somebody and that their ancestors had history, that their ancestors were doctors, lawyers, physicians.
We involve the youth in inventorying and sketch, you know, etching the headstones, and to actually have them do a genealogy research. They identify a few different headstones. They're able to identify the Buffalo soldiers who are buried here and people who predate the Buffalo soldiers are here. The kids did a biography that brought to life some of the people who are buried here at the cemetery. That was a great way of involving them, and they had such a great time.
Call them up and tell them what you need. Tell them what you want. Tell them what you want. Tell them what you want. Call them up and tell them what you need.
And I recall when there wasn't no student mob through there. Wasn't no such thing in those streets, it was all woods. And one little street run down across the railroad tracks all the way into the grade. That was the main entrance. And homes, people lived over in there at that time. But when they dug in the 50s, they dug up all those headstones and skeletons. I don't know what they did with them. But the first part of this warehouse here, that's where part of that was the grave. All up in there was the graveyard at one time.
So what's the local sheriff going to do? He can't enforce a law. He can't provide enforcement because there simply is no penalty associated with any of these cemetery laws. And that's where the community, that's where we have to intervene.